So in this session, let us see some digital solutions for thermometer. The sudden surge in number of COVID-19 cases has caused the nation across the globe to take steps to stop spreading. Ever since the outbreak of this deadly disease, there has been a need to routine check of temperatures. The first step in preventing the cross-contamination is to measure and screen the person who may have fever, which is one of the main symptoms of COVID-19. The measurement of temperature in such case cannot be done using a mercury thermometer or a simple digital thermometer, because all those measurements are based on contact. So instead of measuring the temperature based on contact based thermometers in schools, colleges or in any public place like malls and hotels, we can make use of forehead thermometers, which is otherwise known as infrared thermometers, which serves as a valuable solution in fighting against the COVID-19. The forehead infrared thermometers provides an instant reading without necessary contact, making it an ideal solution for COVID-19 and protect ourselves from getting infected. However, this infrared thermometers which are available in the market are mostly very expensive. So in this video, let us see how to design our own cost-effective infrared thermometer in a simple step using Thinkercad. So what you're seeing in the display is the circuit diagram of infrared based thermometer, which consists of an Arduino microcontroller, an infrared temperature sensor and a LCD display. Here the sensor would cost around 650 rupees in Amazon or Flipkart, or it may be any kind of online purchasing sites. A microcontroller will cost around 400 to 500 rupees, and the display is actually optional. We can manage using LED indicators to indicate high fever. So the total cost of designing will be around 1200. And if a 3D printer is available with your side, you can go for a 3D printed cabinet, or you can make use of some waste cardboards or thermocol sheets for constructing the cabinet. So now let us go into the short demo on this infrared thermometers. So now let us see the demo of infrared thermometer. So the components required for this design are, we need a microcontroller, in our case let it be Arduino UNO. Let us make it a little smaller. Then we need two LED indicators. This LED indicator represents the severity of the fever. So this LED, red LED, indicates it is a high fever, and let us make the other one green, which is representing normal. So we need two resistors. We are utilizing two resistors for safeguarding the LED, and we need a temperature sensor. In this case, as the Thinkercad doesn't have this infrared thermometer or temperature sensor, what I'm going to use is, I'm just going to use a temperature sensor that is TMP36. So this is a three terminal temperature sensor, so which consists of a power terminal and ground terminal and a signal terminal, that is Vout. So these are the components required for developing a temperature sensor or a thermometer. So first let us connect the sensor. So the first pin is the power pin. So I'm just trying to connect this power pin to the 5 volt of the Arduino. So in order to power up the temperature sensor. Secondly, we need a ground. So I'm just going to utilize the ground pin which is there available in the Arduino. So I'm using this ground pin. Then, and the third pin is your Vout pin. As we have seen earlier, we have seen a couple of sensors, but all those sensors are digital sensors. Now what you are going to see is this is an analog sensor. This TMP36 is an analog sensor, so we cannot connect it to a digital pin. So I am just going to connect it to the analog pin which is there available in the Arduino. So I am just going to try connect it to the analog pin A0 in the Arduino. Now let us try to change the color. So as this is a power pin, let it be in a red color, and this is a ground pin, so let it be in black color, and this is your signaling pin, so I'm just giving a blue color, right? So now we have two LEDs remaining for connections. So first let me connect the cathode of this red LED. So this cathode has to be connected with the ground of your Arduino. I'll connect it. So the other terminal is your anode terminal. Now I've connected a resistor in between. From the other end of the resistor, I'm just going to connect to some digital pin which is there available in the Arduino. That would be pin number D7. So I'm just connecting it to the pin number D7. So let us change the color for the wire. So let it be in black color for ground and red color for the power. And similarly, we have to connect the other LED. So I'm just going to connect the other LED. So now I'm just connecting the cathode part. So I'm just going to connect it to the ground, so you can connect as many number of ground in a single pin. If you are using a breadboard, it is not going to make much effort for taking many pins from ground. So I'm just going to connect the other terminal, so other terminal of the LED. I'm just going to drag a line or a wire, and then going to connect it to a digital pin in the Arduino. So let us change the color. So let it be in red color, and the other terminals be in black color. Oh, sorry. Let it be in black color, and let this be in red color. So this is the connection part for the thermometer. So in this space we have just used a TMP sensor instead of infrared sensor, so that is we can replace this TMP sensor with this IR based temperature sensor. This consists of four terminals which are VIN and ground, that is 5 volt and ground. The other two pins are serial clock line and serial data pins. So both these pins will also be a lock pin. So now let us get into the coding part. So let us click this code editor, and we'll try to remove the existing code. So as I told earlier, this will be working in a condition based or a logic based. So whenever the temperature is increasing beyond 100 degree, your red LED should be glowing. When your temperature is increasing, decreasing beyond below 100 degree, your green LED should glow. So this is what is the condition. Now let us program for this particular condition. So now let us go into the control. So again, we need a if else control. So we'll give the control statement. So that is, we'll take this hexagonal block. So what you are going to do is you have connected this temperature sensor to a analog pin. So what you have to do is you have to set the condition for reading the analog pin. So I'm just going to select the input pin. So that is, you are just going to read the analog pin A0. So you are just going to read the analog pin A0. Now you have to set the condition, that is whenever your analog pin A0 is going beyond 100 degree or greater than or equal to 100, you are going to make it as 100. So what should happen? So this is what is the output. So in the if case, what you have to do is you have to select this particular set pin block. So you are going to make the first LED to glow, that is your red LED. So whenever your temperature is going beyond 100 degree, you have to set your pin number. The red LED is connected to pin number 7, so your pin number 7 has to be high. Now your green LED has to be in turned off situation when the temperature is high. So what you have to do is, again you have to select the set pin here and you have to fix the block here. So your green LED is connected to pin number 4. So what you have to do is, you have to select the pin number 4 here and you have to make it low. So similarly, we have to concentrate on the else case. Else case, again you are going to set the pin here. So you have to select the pin number 7. So in this else case, your red LED has to be in a turned off situation and your green LED has to be in the turned up situation, like it has to be high. So this is the condition and we are done with the program. Now let us check the simulation, right? Now I'm just starting the simulation. So it is initializing. Now at the beginning you can see that your red LED is glowing. I'm just clicking this temperature sensor and we have a knob over here. When I'm just bringing the temperature below 100 degrees centigrade, what happens? Your green LED is glowing and your red LED is turned off. So when I'm just going above the 100 degree, what happens? Your red LED is glowing and your green LED is turned off. Even you can see what is happening inside this knob, that is, what is the temperature, what is the present temperature. So for that we have to do simple change in a simple addition in the code. So before that, let us stop the simulation. Let us go into the code to see what is the present present temperature. So we have to select this print to serial monitor. So this block you have to select it. So what you are going to print, you are just going to print the analog pin A0. So you are just going to print the analog pin A0. So this is what is the change you are going to do. And here you can see a serial monitor. Through the serial monitor you can view what is the present temperature which is going on. So again, let us start the simulation here. I'm just starting the simulation and it is initializing. So now I'm just opening the code here. So you can see the serial monitor running here. So it is showing a temperature of 153 degrees in degree here. So I'm just moving on the knob here. That is, I'm just bringing down the temperature. So when I'm bringing down the temperature, you can see the temperature value is getting changed here, and at the same time your LED indicator has changed to green color. Now your red LED has stopped working. So whenever I'm just increasing the temperature, when it is going beyond 100 degree, what happens? Your green LED turned off and your red LED is turned on. So this is the demo for temperature sensor, or that is your thermometer, digital thermometer. So you can make use of a simple LCD display instead of going with LED. Couple of LEDs we saw in the previous demo, that is red and green LED, where red indicates your high fever and green indicates your normal. So this is the circuit diagram for connecting a LCD display to a Arduino. So here you can see a VSS that has to be grounded, and VCC is nothing but your 5 volt supply for this LCD display, and this VEE will be connected to a potentiometer of 10 kilo ohm. So this three are combined together to increase the contrast of this particular LCD module. So then we are just going to connect the reset to pin number 12, and then we are just going to connect the read write to the ground, and we are just going to connect the enable pin to pin number 11 of your Arduino, and we are just going to leave blank these four pins, that is your DB0 to DB3, and DB4, DB5, DB6 and DB7 is being connected with 5, 4, 3 and 2 pins of your Arduino, and remaining will be having 2 pins in your LCD display, that is your LED plus and LED minus. This LED plus will be connected to a 5 volt power supply with a resistance of 560 ohm, and the LED minus will be connected to the ground. So this is what is the connection to connect a LCD display to an Arduino. So we can make use of this also. So let us see a short demo of connecting this particular LCD display with an Arduino for verifying the temperature, or for the same concept, that is your digital thermometer using your LED display, LCD display. So now let us open our Thinkercad. So I've already connected it. We'll just simulate it and we'll just verify this. I've already made the connection as per the circuit diagram which I showed you earlier, and again I'm using a TMP36 sensor, as we don't have an infrared sensor in Thinkercad. Now let us start the simulation. While starting the simulation, you can see that your LED display is glowing. Now what I'm just going to do is, I'm going to follow the same procedure. I'm just going to click on this temperature sensor. I'm just going to rock on this particular knob. Now what I'm just going to do is, I'm just going to slowly increase the temperature. You can see that the temperature is getting increased. So in this same condition, you can replace this temperature sensor with an infrared sensor, so that when you are focusing on the forehead of a particular person, so the temperature details will be printed on this LCD screen. So you can see the changes happening in the LCD display. So here we are not going to use any kind of indicators, but instead we are just going to make use of a LCD display, so that whenever there is a change in the temperature, this will be indicated in the LCD. So this is a short demo with this LCD display. So now let us see the next digital solution, which is disinfectant tunnel. The wake of the COVID-19 outbreak, this disinfectant tunnel are emerging as it is one of the important strategy. The principle behind this strategy is simple actually. Just wash your hands, walk through a tunnel for few seconds, and this can considerably reduce the number of germs sticking into you. While walking through this tunnel, the overhead sprayer sprinkles the disinfectant or the sanitizer. This disinfectant tunnel can be installed at markets, schools, colleges and other public places like hospitals and malls, where we can witness large number of people every day. So in this video, let us see how to construct a disinfectant tunnel in simple steps using Thinkercad, and later on which can be implemented in the real time using a microcontroller and sensors. The components required for constructing this tunnel are a microcontroller. In our case, let it be a Arduino microcontroller, a PIR sensor, a water pump, a sanitizer tank with disinfectant solution, light indicators and other hardwares for constructing the tunnel setup. Now let us see a demo on how to digitally construct a disinfectant tunnel using a microcontroller. So this is the model for the proposed disinfectant tunnel. So you can see a tunnel-like protection here. So it consists of a solution tank, a water pump, a controller. In our case, we are going to use Arduino microcontroller. Here we'll be having that spraying nozzles, and we'll be having light indicators and a PIR sensor. So whenever a person is walking through this tunnel, what happens, this PIR sensor detects that motion, and now what happens, your red LED glows. Whenever there is a person who is moving inside the tunnel, it will be represented with a red LED. So when there is no person inside the tunnel, it will be represented with a green LED. So at the same time, whenever your PIR sensor senses a motion inside the tunnel, it instructs the microcontroller. The microcontroller in turn, it controls the motor so that the valve get opens. The motor's valve will get open so that the solution inside the tank will be flowing through this pipe, and it will be sprayed through this nozzle, and the person going through this tunnel will be disinfected with that sanitizer solution. So this is our proposed model for a simple disinfectant tunnel. So now let us see the basic components in our ThinkCAD. So I've opened my workspace in the ThinkCAD. Now I'm just going to select the basic components which are required. As usual, I'm just taking the Arduino IDE. So I'm just placing over here. So what are the other things which are required is your LED indicators, as this is to indicate whether the person is there inside the tunnel or not. Then I need a PIR motion sensor. So using this only, it is identified whether the person is walking inside or staying inside. Then I need a motor to represent that the pump is getting on or off. So I'm just going to use a DC motor in the space. So what else is required is I need a relay module. This will be very similar to that of that pump which we saw in the earlier video, that is automatic hand sanitizer we saw, no? Which will be very similar to that model, but you can see some changes here. So I am placing the relay module here. So now our task is to connect the PIR sensor. So this PIR sensor will be having three terminals. First one is your signal terminal, and the second one is your power terminal, and the third one is your ground terminal. So as usual, let us start connecting with the PIR sensor. So whenever there is a motion under this PIR motion sensor's surveillance, it identifies the motion and it instructs the Arduino microcontroller. This Arduino microcontroller in turn will control the pump, so that this pump will eject the sanitizer solution through this spraying nozzle. Okay, so I'm just trying to connect the signal wire. So this should be a digital sensor, so I'm just connecting it to a digital pin 4. So second one is your power pin, so I'm just connecting the power pin to the pin number 5 volt. Then is the ground pin, so I'm just connecting it to the ground pin in the Arduino. So I'm just connected it. So let us change the color of the wire. So this is the signal pin, so I'm just changing it to blue color, and this is a ground pin, so I'm just changing it to black, and this is power pin, I'm changing it to red, and this is your ground pin, I'm changing it to black. So this is the connection for your PAR sensor. So now let us connect the LEDs. So as usual, we need to connect it to the ground. So the cathode has to be grounded. So similarly, we'll connect the cathode of this LED also to the ground. So now we need a resistor to safeguard the LED. So I'm just placing an LED here, another LED for the next indicator, and before that we'll change the color of the LED. This color be in green color. Okay, so I'm just connecting the red LED to pin number 7 and connecting the green LED to pin number 8. So this is the connection for the indicators. So let us change the color. Let this ground wire be in a black color and this power wire be in red color. Similarly for the next indicator, black and red. So now it's time to connect the motor. So now let us connect the relay module. So I'm just connecting the relay module to pin number 13 here. I'm just connecting the other end of the relay module with the ground. I've connected to ground. So we also need a battery. As I've told earlier that we need a battery to run this motor, because the power supplied by the Arduino will not be sufficient for running a motor. So I'm just making use of a additional 9 volt battery. So I'm just connecting this one of the terminal. That is the negative terminal to the negative terminal of the battery. Now I'm just connecting the positive terminal of the motor to terminal 6. Then I'm just connecting the terminal 12 to the positive of the 9 volt battery. So this is what is the connection for connecting the motor. So now let us change the color of the wire. So this is a signal wire, so I'm just changing it to blue. So this is a ground wire, so I'm changing it to black. And again, this is a power wire, so I'm changing it to red. And this is a ground wire, I'm changing it to black. And again, this is also a power wire, I'm changing it to red. So this is what is the circuit diagram for your disinfectant tunnel. Now let us look at the coding part. So I'm clicking the code editor now. So remove the existing code here. So again, here also we are just going to use a conditional statement, that is if else. So I'm just going to take a hexagonal block. So what we are just going to read, we are just going to read the sensor value. To which pin the sensor value is connected? It is connected to the digital pin 4. So we have to select the input and we have to choose this particular block, that is read the digital pin 4. So whenever it is equal to this, is either you can keep it as 1 or you can keep it as high. So in the math operation, you can select high and you can place it over here. So whenever the digital pin 4 is equal to high, that is whenever the PAR sensor detects some motion, this is the condition. So what it has to do? So now let us go to the output. So now let us choose this set pin 0 to high. So set pin 0 to high, first we have to select so which LED indicator has to glow. So whenever a person is passing through the tunnel, it has to be indicated with the red light. So I'm just choosing pin number 7 as I have connected the red LED to pin number 7. So similarly, at the same time it has to turn on the motor which is connected to it. So I'm just selecting again the same block. So the motor pin is connected to pin number 13. So I'm just going to make pin number 13 as high. So then your green LED has to be in an off state. So I'm just selecting the set pin again, and green LED is being connected to pin number 8. So pin number 8 has to be kept low. So this is your if statement. So now let us come into the else part. So again we'll select the set pin here. So we have to set pin number 7 to low. That is your turning off the red LED. Then you have to again select the set pin here. So now you are just going to select the pin number 13, that is your motor pin, that has to be low. And again you are going to select the set pin. This represents your green LED, and green LED is connected to pin number 8. So this is what is the program for your disinfectant tunnel. Now let us try to simulate it. Now let us close this and start the simulation. Now it has been initialized. So now it has been started to simulate. So I'm just clicking the PR sensor. Now there is no motion inside the surveillance area of your PR sensor. So your green light is glowing. So when there is a motion inside the surveillance area, that is when some person is walking inside the tunnel, the red light glows, and at the same time you can see that motor is running here. So the motor has been running here. So when there is no motion inside the tunnel, you can see that the green LED is glowing, and at the same time your motor stops running. So you can again see a demo, like whenever the person is moving inside the tunnel, the red LED glows, and you can see at the same time the motor is being running. When there is no motion inside the tunnel, the green LED glows and the motor stops running, or the motor stops pumping the sanitizer, so that we can save the sanitizer from unwantedly spraying inside the tunnel. And at the same time, whenever a person is moving inside, it is being utilized efficiently. So this is the demo for a disinfectant tunnel. So this code can be directly utilized for real-time application. So as I told, if you click this block drop down to block plus test, you can find the code for applying this program for a real-time application, so that you can just copy this code and you can paste it in your Arduino IDE. You can compile it, download it, and you can test this program in the real time. Or you can just go for this download, so that when you are clicking this download, your INO file will be getting downloaded. By opening that, you can directly download this program inside your Arduino IDE. So this is what is the demo for the disinfecting tunnel. Thank you. So thank you for watching our video on digital solutions for COVID-19 problem. I think this video would have given a small insight about how to use Arduino and how to handle ThinkerCAD online tool. So please do subscribe our YouTube channel so that you will be notified with all new technical videos whichever we publish from our Francis Xavier Engineering College. Thank you.